When this game was first announced, combined with the fact that EA was involved, I was extremely skeptical as to how this game was going to turn out. As we all know by now, most things that EA touches turns to garbage. Look at how they did the Battlefield series. I mean, yikers. But knowing Respawn Entertainment would be the ones developing the game, I knew there could be a diamond in the rough here at the same time. Titanfall 2 is one of the most underrated shooters I've ever played. That game did not receive as much attention as it should have, for real. Even Apex Legends, which actually got a lot of attention, couldn't revive Titanfall 2. So, this video is to you, Respawn. Let's give you some well-deserved attention for a game based off of the gameplay you've clearly put some work into. The focus of Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order centers around a former Padawan named Cal Kestis, who survived the Clone Wars and fall of the Jedi Order. Cal tries to settle down and stay hidden in the aftermath of these events. Can't really blame the guy, dude almost got blasted in the back by like 60 stormtroopers. Anyway, blah blah blah, he gets discovered by the Empire and must defend himself, learning how to become a Jedi in the process. So, definitely an interesting plotline to say the least. But the thing that's caught my eye the most so far is the gameplay. Ooh, check this out. Automatically transition to battle, okay, with a badass zing of that lightsaber. A lock-on system, okay, okay, rolls, stamina, limited heals. Alright, this is Dark Souls 4 confirmed. Dark Souls 4, just lock that in. I mean, deflect blasts just like a Jedi, use the force to throw around your enemies, pull off some sick acrobatics while whirling around your lightsaber. I love how this combat looks. The animations look really fluid, the attacks and rolls all flow well together, and are a pleasure to watch play out on screen. Imagine being immersed in a fight against this monster, timing your dodges perfectly, and you're barely able to clutch out a win with a gnarly execution animation. Ooh, that's so cool. Ooh, that's cool. To dive a bit deeper into the specifics, there seems to be a bar that indicates how long you can deflect blasts. Once the bar runs out, Cal gets guard broken and can no longer deflect the blasts anymore. There also seems to be two types of dodges, a sidestep and a dodge roll. A sidestep for when you time that dodge just right, which can allow you to retaliate quickly, and a dodge roll to be more generous if you miss time a little bit, with less time to retaliate against the enemy. Attacking seems quite slow though and has a long startup, and it's not entirely clear to me whether there would be a mix of light and heavy attacks like Dark Souls. But at the same time, this is probably why you want to time your attacks accordingly. There's also a pretty ridiculous attention to detail here in that you can see the burn marks that your lightsaber leaves across your enemies as you attack them. Of course, this wouldn't be a Star Wars game without Force abilities, but certain enemies seem to be able to resist your Force abilities. Sure, you can force this Stormtrooper riffraff and shove your lightsaber into Jeff here and throw him aside like Wednesday's garbage, but ooh, Tommy here? Ooh, Tommy ain't gonna go out like that. There are definitely going to be Force and lightsaber abilities that you can upgrade and techniques that you can learn as you progress throughout the game, so that can also change the way you approach combat. Certain attacks are unblockable, indicated when the enemy flashes red, so you've got to react quick enough to dodge that attack. Parries can be executed by guarding at the last second, which can be a devastating and swift way to take down your enemies. Systems like this really gets me excited, guys. This is how you do combat in a video game, and the Star Wars universe really allows for a lot of possibilities. I mean, just look at some of these mini-bosses. They look absolutely insane. Look at these lightsaber duels. I'm literally about to be like... And it's not just the combat. The exploration looks very fun to get around in the world of Jedi Fallen Order as well. Leave it to Respawn to have some spectacular looking movement, and of course they had to incorporate that classic wall running. There are also some really interesting platforming sections that you'll have to use your Force abilities to complete, which can make for some interesting puzzles as well. This game doesn't seem to be a linear experience either. You can explore the open world as you please, and hopefully there will be some cool side quests where you can get some extra gear and skill points. I definitely do see a small amount of gear progression, so we'll have to wait for the game's release to know for sure, There is a workbench where the player can upgrade BD1, which I can only assume increases how many heals you can have in a fight, as BD1 is what Cal uses to heal himself, after all. According to the game's director, you can also change lightsaber colors and can freely customize your lightsaber to how you want it. As to whether that will be solely cosmetics or will also include functionality and upgrades as well to the lightsaber, we'll have to wait and see. Regardless, I hope watching this video and seeing some gameplay has gotten you guys hyped for this game, as I'm not even that big of a Star Wars fan, and I'm amped to play this game. I'll definitely be live streaming the game over on Twitch, so you guys should check the description for a link to my channel where you can watch me play through the game over there. Also, don't forget to like this video and subscribe, guys, if you enjoyed. Otherwise, the Force is not gonna be with you. I'm sorry.